benefit of the doubt before him again.
Well, after last night, I don't think there could be any doubt about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey today.
I told you, Sister Berta.
But she was late.
Sister Sophia, they do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
Oh, I love her very dearly, but she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I say. She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee. Her dress has got a tear.
She waltzes on her way to mass and whistles on the stair.
And underneath her window she has colors in her hair.
I even heard her singing in the Abbey.
She's always late for chapel, but her penitence is real. She's always late for everything except for I hate to have to say it, but I'm very firmly feeling Maria's not an answer to the Abbey.
I'd like to say a word on her behalf.
Then say it to Maria.
Maria makes me laugh.
How do you solve a problem like Maria?
How do you catch a cloud and pin it down?
Bright copper kettles and wooden mittens, brown paper pads.
sad and sadness. Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes. Silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Mother, where did you learn that song?
I was brought up on that mountain myself. Tell me, what is the most important lesson you've learned here?
To find out what is the will of God and to do it.
Maria, it seems to be the will of God that you leave us.
Leave? Oh no, Mother, this is what I want. This is my life.
But are you ready for it? Perhaps if you go out into the world again for a time, you will return to us knowing what we expect of you. And that we do expect it.
I know what you expect.
Maria,
if it is the will of God, where am I to go?
There's a family. A family of 7 children. They need a governess until September.
September?
The captain von Trapp expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man and a great one. He was given a medal for heroism in the Adriatic.
But Mother, a captain in the Navy, he'll be very strict.
You're not going to save his badge.
Why did the last one sleep?
Who knows? All she said was, I had enough of this, and walked out.
Well, there's another one coming today, though not very happy. With orders to stay until September.
I do hope you'll be at home for a time, sir.
I should be back from Vienna in a few weeks.
Oh, there's a call for you, sir. From Vienna. I have the number.
I know the number.
Of course, sir. You wait here.
I'm Captain von Trapp. You are Fraulein?
Maria Rainer.
Now, Fraulein, as to your duties, before the children meet you, you will put on another dress.
But I have another dress. When we entered the abbey, all our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
Poor didn't want this one. I would have made my own dress, but I wasn't given the time. I do make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you are given some material. Today, if possible. Now, you are in charge of my children. There are 7. We'll see how far they progress in their studies and carry on from there. Each morning will be spent in the classroom. Each afternoon, they will march. At all times, you will see that they conduct themselves with orderliness and decorum. The first rule in this house is discipline.
Yes, sir.
This is your Fraulein, new governess, Fraulein Maria. As I sound your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fraulein, listen and learn their signals. Now, Fraulein, what I want you this way here.
You need a treble, sir, for I couldn't answer to a whistle.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. A I'll show you. My butler Franz, this is Fräulein Maria, the new governess. Please make sure her room is ready.
Yes, sir.
Pardon me, sir. I don't know how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return your whistle, Captain. I won't be needing it, Captain. Are you leaving us, Captain?
I will be in Vienna on business, and when I return, I expect a report on the children's progress, and on yours. You're in command.
Well, now that it's just us, why don't you each come forward and tell me your names again, and tell me how old you are. Now you're...
I'm Lizzie. I'm 16 years old, and I don't need a governess.
I'm glad you told me. We'll just be good friends.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14, and I'm a boy.
Boy? I thought you were almost a man.
I'm Brigida.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Brigitte. She's Louisa. She's 13 years old, and you're smart. I'm 9, and I think your dress is the ugliest one I ever saw.
Brigitte, you mustn't say that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
If I did think so, I wouldn't say so. I'm Kurt. I'm 11. Almost.
That's a nice age to be, 11, almost.
I'm Marta, and I'll be 7 on Tuesday, and I would like a pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you must be Gretel. I'm going to tell you something. I've never been a governess before. How do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about being a governess?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do is tell Father to mind his own business.
No, Louisa, don't. I like her.
What's in there?
My guitar from when we all sing together.
We don't sing.
Everybody sings. What songs do you know?
We don't know any songs.
You don't?
No.
Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
I'm
Listen.
Father gets a birthday telegram from his sister. Can I come again tomorrow night?
tell.
You can't be sure you're going to have my telegram to deliver tomorrow night.
Well, I could come here by mistake with a telegram for Colonel Schneider. He's here from Berlin. No one's supposed to know he's here, so don't tell your father.
Why not?
Well, your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Some people think we all speak German. They're pretty mad at those who don't think so.
Well, I'm sure they'll have forgotten all about it by the time father comes back. Don't worry.
The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you, please?
16. What's wrong with that?
You wait, little girl, on an empty stage for fate to turn the light on. Your life, little girl, is an empty page that men will want to write on.
To write on.
You are 16,
going on 17, baby, it's time to think. Better be wary, happy, and careful, baby, you're on the brink.
You are 16,
going on 17, fellows will fall in by. Eager young lads and food ways and cads will offer you food and wine. Totally unprepared are you to face a world of men. Timid and shy and scared of you, of things beyond your ken.
You need someone older and wiser telling you what to do. I am 17, going on 18, I'll take care of you.
Kurt.
Why does it do that?
Well, the lightning says something to the together, we won't be able to hear the thunder. Now, just imagine. High on a hill, someone in daughter, lay a lay a lay. Loud was the voice, someone in daughter, lay a lay a lay. Books in the town, that sprang from motor, lay a lay a lay. Lusty clear, whose girl turns fairer, lay a lay a lay.
Because my motto is, never start looking for people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning London, Rome, Paris, Stockholm.
On my telephone?
Well, how else could I afford it? Me, the lowly third Secretary of Ministry of Education and Culture. Georg, just out of curiosity, is there a cathedral around here?
Dornberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good! I'll have to pay them a visit.
What do you want?
Oh, Captain, Hiya!
Who are you?
I have a telegram here for Air Jet Violet.
I am Air Jet Violet.
You've delivered your telegram, now get out!
Georg, you're just a boy.
I'm Austrian, I'll not be Hiya.
Georg, why don't you look at the way things I do? What's going to happen is going to happen. Just don't let it happen to you.
Air Jet Violet, there's a call for you from...
Thank you, Franz.
Excuse me, Georg.
Get into your uniforms and report back here at once! Fräulein, where do you get these abominations? Out of a nightmare?
No, out of some old curtains. The curtains that used to hang in my bedroom.
Do you mean to say that people of the neighborhood have seen my children wearing old curtains?
Oh yes, they've become very popular. Everyone always says, oh look, there goes the Montrap children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
The captain, they weren't. They're just unhappy little marching machines.
I don't care to hear from you about my children.
I know you don't, but you've got to. Take Liesl. Liesl isn't a child anymore. And Captain, if you keep treating her as one, you're going to have a mutiny on your hands.
I said I don't want to hear.
I know you don't, but take Friedrich. Friedrich's shy, he's aloof. Friedrich's scared to be himself. He needs your confidence.
Don't tell me about my son.
Brigitte can tell you about him. She can tell you a lot more if you got to know her, because she notices things. And she always tells the truth, especially when you don't want to hear it. I haven't finished yet. Marta, I don't know about her yet, but someone's got to find out about her. And little girl just wants to be loved. Oh, please, Captain,
stop it! We'll pack your things and return to the Abbey as soon as possible.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said those things. Not the way that I said them.
As soon as you've gone, he'll be... What's that?
Singing.
Who's singing?
Your children.
My children? Singing?
You must hear this!
Frau Maria, you won't be having dinner now with the children. They'll be having dinner down here with us.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes, well, you'll have to change. We're sorry.
Well then, ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Before we go to dinner, the Longchamp children would like to say good night, as only they can.
I was frightened.
Frightened?
I was confused. I never felt that way before, and I knew that here I'd be away from it, that here it would be safe.
Maria, our Abbey is not to be used as an escape.
But I couldn't face them again, those feelings.
Maria, are you in love with Captain Montrack?
Brigida said that I was, and that her father was in love with me. But I was there for God's errand. To have asked for the captain's love would have been wrong.
Maria, the love of a man and a woman is holy, too. What you must find out is how does God want you to spend your love?
I pledged my life to God's service.
If you love this man, it doesn't mean you love God less. You must find out. You must go back.
Oh, no, Mother, please!
These walls are not meant to shut out problems. You have to face them. You have to find the life you were born to live.
But how do I find it?
Look for it.
Leaving now.
Fraulein. I'm all right.
Any telegrams lately?
No, Fraulein. Now I'll be glad to go to boarding school.
Because so if you can't use boarding school to escape your problems, you have to face them.
Fraulein Maria, you come back.
Yes, Captain.
Liesl?
Louisa, Brigitte, boys. Maria will be in the garden.
Father will be happy
now.
Maria, can you dress?
You have a new costume.
You left without any explanation whatsoever, without even saying goodbye.
It was wrong of me.
What made you come back?
The Mother Abbess, she said that you have to look for your life.
Often when you find it, you don't recognize it.
No.
And one day, one night, all of a sudden it stands before you.
Yes.
I look at you now, and I realize this isn't something that just happened. You knew it too. What was it that told you?
Brigida, when we were dancing at the party.
She was quite right. That wasn't an ordinary dance, was it?
I had a dance since I was a very little girl. It's much different after you've grown up, isn't it?
I know now I can't do it. We'll have to get out of Austria right away. And we can't just pick up and leave. They'll be watching us for now. We need time.
Sir, General Schreiber is here to see you.
Thank you, Franz. Please bring him in. They didn't give us time.
Then we'll make time.
Stormtroopers! This is what I was afraid of, Maria.
Please, look, I need the children, quickly.
You must be careful. Max, I need you now. Keep your head above you.
Don't I always?
May I present Maximilian Detweiler?
First Secretary of the Ministry of Education and Culture. That was the old regime.
In the old regime, I was the third secretary. Now I'm the first secretary.
How nice to have friends. Do you care to sit down?
No, thank you. We're here on business. A telegram was sent to you 3 days ago.
I've just received it.
Captain Von Trapp has just returned from his honeymoon, sir.
Congratulations, Captain. Now, let's get down to business. Your orders are to report immediately to the naval base at Bremerhaven.
That's very flattering, Admiral, but I've had no time to consider.
Immediately? I'm afraid that would be impossible, Georg.
May I present my wife, the Baroness Von Trapp?
What I mean, sir, is that we're performing the Salzburg Festival Friday night. You see, the Von Trapp family singers.
2 days, but on Friday? And besides, it gives here only the names of the children.
It says the Von Trapp family singers. I am head of the Von Trapp family.
It's hard to imagine you, Captain, singing in a concert.
Admiral Schreiber, you may believe whatever you choose.
And it doesn't say here what you're going to sing. What are you going to sing, Captain?
It will be your privilege to come to the concert and hear us.
I'd like to hear you sing now.
Children?
Sing something for us. Sing! Sing!
Oh, a deer, a female deer, red, a drop of golden sun. A name I call myself.
Far along the way to run.
Ladies and gentlemen, the festival of the concert has come to its conclusion. Except, of course, we don't know what that conclusion is going to be. As our judges put their heads together to arrive at their decision, I think we should have an encore. This may be the very last time that the Von Trapp family have to sing together for a long, long time. I've just been informed that Captain Von Trapp leaves from this hall to his new position in the Naval Forces of the Third Reich. A guard of honor has come to escort him from this hall to the naval base in Bremerhaven. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the family Von Trapp, again. Judges. We will start with the third award. For this honor, the judges have named the duo of Sangerbund and Haraway. Thank you for coming. The second award has been given to Fräulein Schweiger, the first soloist of St. Agatha's Church in Murbach. And now, the first award, the first prize, the highest in the land, goes to the Family Von Trapp. The Family Von Trapp.
I used to look at these mountains as my friends, watching over us, protecting us. Now they look as my enemies.
Never your enemies. Haven't you read? I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help.
Darren, you know this mountain as well as I do. And once we're over it, we're in Switzerland.
Well, what about the children?
We can help them.
Father, you can do it without help.
You'll have help. For ye shall go out with joy, and be led forth with peace. And the mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing.
Thank you.
have flowers. And first person we want to thank is Jim, who did an awesome job playing the piano. So the next person is Miss Marinades, who helped us choreograph all our dances. So thank you. Thank you. And then finally, our director Nancy Berry, who has put up with us for the past couple months, and we want to thank you especially because you made all this happen. So, there you go.